Hi, I'm Hema. So today my topic is automate the network with WebGUI with a Pi network. So the Pi network is a tool that I developed to maintain and troubleshooting the network. Again, I'm Hema, so you can reach me out at this LinkedIn URL as well as you can reach me out the pinetwork.net for more information about this product. So I've been in the network industry for the last 5 years. Also, I'm teaching the networking stuff. So nowadays, I'm very passionate about the network automation, developing tools for the simplifying the network maintenance and troubleshooting. So let's get started. So these are the contents that I'm going to deliver today. The first one is the introduction of the Pi network, that a product I develop, and the Pi network architecture, the second one. The third one is going to be the API flows and as well as the demos so that I have that. So the last one is going to be the resources. So the Pi network is a WebGUI tool, so you can maintain and troubleshooting the network. So these are the current features that are available in the Pi network. The first one is the inventory. So it's all about you can add and remove or the manage the or the edit the network devices or the network node information inside to the Pi network database. So that's all about it. WebCLI, you can send the show commands as well as the configuration to push to the device or the multiple devices. So these are all about the WebCLI. The configuration backups, you can manage your running config and you can export it and you can delete those kind of stuff. It's going to be there. This is the high level architecture of the Pi network. This is the front end as well as this is the back end. For the front end, I use the React frameworks and that's created by the Facebook. And with that, I use the Material UI. So the Material UI allows us to create the HTML and CSS components without doing any coding like HTML and CSS. So it's allowed to create the web application and components very easily. So we can use it the React. So for the backend, I use Flask as a backend server. So it's getting the request from the front end and it will processing the data and send back to the front end. The front end will render this information and showing to the database. That's what I'm all about it. With the backend, I'm using the NetMiko and the SQL Alchemy, the two frameworks that I'm using. The NetMiko is more focused on the interact with the network devices, actually the infrastructure. And the SQL Alchemy is all about making the interaction with the database in this Pi network. I just use the SQLite as a database. So with SQL Alchemy, we don't need to worry about writing or querying the SQL. So SQL Alchemy will take care about that. You can see this is the Pi network dashboard. So when you click this button, this is the inventory is all about. So here you can see entire devices that I added to the Pi network. From here, there's an option to export this information. So you can export as a PDF as well as CSV. So I'm exporting as a PDF. So from here, I'm just exporting and you can view this data, all the device information. So the username as well as the host name and the port. So this is the one of the options available. So if you go through it, this is the API flows is going to work. So when we load the the Pi network, first one is when I click in this inventory, so it is passed the information to the client application. So when the user is interacting with the click button, and the React front end will send the inventory get request to the Flask, and the Flask will process this data and it will get to the request to the SQL database and it will get back the response from this and is passed to the front end to the React. So then the front end will render and it will show to the user. So that's all about it. So the second one is inventory management. So we'll go through that one. Inventory management is all about creating, edit, and as well as create and edit and delete the information. So If you already I have added some devices, so if I want to delete these records from the Pi network, so I can click this button and it will ask, so yes or no. So if I click yes, so it's going to be deleted. So this is about the function called delete. So also I can edit this information. So there's a user is for this IP address, there's a user is Cisco and just making as a pop, and I just mean type. You can see now we can able to add this information, as well as if I want to add new user or sorry the new device information, so I can click the add button, as well as I can put the IP like 10.10.10.10 and the username is Heman. Port number is 22. I'm just mentioning passwords. Yeah, you can see this IP address is here. So also we have an option to sort it out, and we also can find it like this. So these are the options available on this inventory management. So let's go with that how the flows are working here. So I'm just opening the slides. So it's all about the collecting the information from the Pi network database. This process we already discussed. So the same process is going to be here. The second process is when we performing the operation like create, update, delete something. So the each application, so each operation is going to map with one of the URL, and I map with a flask route. So when the CRUD option is going, so Flask application will get the request and it will modify the database with the SQL Alchemy. So in this case, SQL Alchemy will interact with the database and it will modify the database and it will get back the response. Then the Flask will send the response to the React router. So once it get back, get the results back from the React perspective, so React server is again send the updated information like the earlier process we discussed. It will fetch the data again and it will display to the user. So that's all about the inventory management. So we can push some configuration to the device. So I can show that one. So I already have some commands and it might be easy for us. So I'm going to select the same device again. So before that we push the configuration, we can confirm that this configuration exists or not. So I'm just running show running config in root username. So you can see only the Cisco username is exist. So we'll try to push this configuration to username information to the to this device. So I'm just clicking this. So at the same time, I'm just bringing back to this last loss. So you can see it's collecting the username credential and it's already logged into this device and waiting for some time. So it also is pushing this configuration to the device, and also we just got the output. Also for the double check, we can confirm. So it's telling is this is the my IP address of my Pi network flag server. So it's telling, so we can confirm from the CLI too. So we can see, we can confirm that it's already, the configuration already pushed. So that's all about the config CLI. So if I go through the API flow for this config CLI, so it's a the same thing. So we just collecting this clicking the config CLI, just collecting the device information. Then the same things going to be happen. So we just sending the config commands, and from here the React will send these commands and the device name. When it's come to the Flask will request the device credential for the particular device credential, and it will get the response, and then it will perform the network with the help of the NetMeCo. It will send the push the configuration to the devices, and it will get the response. Then it will pass to the front end, and front end will display it to the user. But so that's all about it. Thanks for watching my videos and stay tuned. So I'm going to put more feature on that. Thank you.